Okay, welcome to the channel, all about the blues harmonica. So if you haven't already, thumbs up and subscribe. All right, today I'm looking at a tune, A Shot in the Dark, Pink Panther film. You may be familiar with the cartoons, or perhaps the films. Of this film, Shot in the Dark, I think it was early 1960s, probably 63, 64, when it first came out. A fantastic series of films, of course. And anybody that knows me extremely well would know the connection I have to those films and the Pink Panther series, but that's something else. All right, today, okay, split it into two bits, because the first bit is probably, although it's just an intro, is probably more for an advanced player. If you're not going that way, intermediate and beyond, don't worry, just miss out the introduction bit that I'm going to show now. And then you'll be able to play the other bit that I show you of the tune. I've done two demonstrations for you. I've done a really flat one where I play over the orchestra with no nuances at all. And I've done an acoustic one where I play with more nuance, because when you play in a small environment with just a few people, like a trio or quartet or a small blues band, you'd use a lot more nuance. When you're playing, say, with a big band, you may put block chords in, you may do, depending. Having said that, I just played this completely flat for you to hear it, because of course you have to be more, you can't be bending around too much on the line, because if you're playing in unison with other people, because it's going to be more precise. We're heading towards that equal temperament thing, which I don't kind of go down that route. Okay, all right, so you might just want to skip over this little first bit if you haven't got that much experience, but then you'll learn all the rest. So the start of this, the intro, so two draw, four draw, six blow, five over blow, five draw, five blow, four over blow, four draw. All right, that's your intro. Okay, so if you're not quite there yet, just skip over that bit. All right, now we've got two draw, four draw, four draw bend, four blow, three draw half step, two draw, all the way down, back up to two again. Two draw all the way down, one draw, one blow, one draw. Again. All right, so those are the notes for the first part of it. I'll put them up there. Now, of course, don't worry, I will play it very marginally different every single time I play, even when I'm coaching it. So the syncopation does change. I tend to be straight flat if I'm playing, obviously, with others playing in unison. Obviously, you have to be in with them, all right, unless you're playing a counterpoint. There's a fantastic, for this particular tune, because of the counterpoint, because you've got that going on all the time. Wow, you're going. Your first A section, all right. Now you fiddle around with that and just go backwards and forwards on my video, nice and slowly, until you get that. Bridge, two draw, three draw half step, four blow, three draw half step, two draw. So straightforward, three draw half step, and then a 3/6 blow, perhaps, or two draw. Next you're going, same thing again, and then hold the four draw. And then go back to two draw. Could play the bridge a little bit like this. See, I'm using the block chord there. But so sometimes I might with a big band, if I was playing that with them, put the whole thing in, but you tend to play more clean because you're all playing together. So it's the same thing every time. That's your four draw again. Now listen. Four draw. Four blow. Half step. Full step. Very, very loosely, okay? I'll stick some notes up where I've, and of course, each time I play it is slightly different. All right, and if you pick up another harp, now let's say I pick up an A harp. Sometimes I want that. There's clean. But sometimes I want the oscillation in the middle. I want that. And I deliberately do it. Probably wouldn't do it if I'm playing with a lot of players or all playing at the same time, but certainly when I'm playing in a small band, because when you're mic'd up and you're... There's clean. But also, I want the oscillation in between. Sometimes I set them up like that deliberately because you get a lot of overtones and it's quite amazing on a live performance when you do that. So there is deliberation in it. It's not a lack of experience or anything like that. It's done deliberately, all right? And you'll play around with it, and sometimes you will get that oscillation by accident. Sometimes you just want to keep it in, and as you develop, don't worry too much. As long as you hit the time to hit the note in the right place, that's the main thing, okay? The most thing is keep the timing. You can play all the wrong notes, providing the timing's right. It's when all the right notes are in the wrong place that the problem occurs. Right, but you'll learn that with experience. Okay, so I hope you enjoy this lesson. I'm deliberately being a little bit loose with how I'm coaching this to give you experience of just hearing and doing as well, you know, see how you go with that. All right, so I think I did the demos on an A harp, but the playing on with the band, also in terms of here, I'd use the C harmonica because I know that most people would have the C harp. All right, you can get me for lessons on Harp Over the Heel of Wicks. As always, podcasts, you might see a link in the description below. As always, I'll catch you on Rebound. Oh,